Stable Diffusion with AMD ROCm on Windows. Will we have a release soon? And is there a way to speed up Stable Diffusion with AMD graphic cards on Windows, just in case ROCm still takes a while? For sure you've heard about AMD's plans to support ROCm on Windows. ROCm is an AMD software stack supporting GPUs. Among other things, it's used to run AI tools like Stable Diffusion. In this video, I'll tell you the status of ROCm on Windows for Stable Diffusion and how to get detailed information. In the second part of the video, I'll show you how to speed up Stable Diffusion on Windows with your AMD GPU. Image generation on Windows with my Radeon 6800 is 7 times faster now. But let's start with ROCm. If you ever have started Stable Diffusion, then you know it depends on PyTorch. On this webpage you see what's required for PyTorch. You find all links in the description below. We choose the nightly build as it includes the most current versions. Select Windows and pip is the package manager for Python. Now if you select ROCm, then you can see ROCm is not available on Windows. But what does it mean? Will ROCm be available someday on Windows? In order to answer these questions, we'll have a look at the related GitHub page. There we can find an issue, ROCm support for Windows. That's quite promising, but as you can see, the issue is still open. Nevertheless, it looks like they really want to support Windows. If we scroll down a bit, then we can see Windows support for PyTorch is currently not available, and AMD is continuing to invest in Windows support. For details, we find a link. Behind this link, you find a list of all ROCm components. And you see the status for Linux and for Windows. As you can see, pip is supported. And exactly that was the AMD announcement regarding ROCm. Pip is a runtime API that can be used to write portable code which can be run both on AMD and NVIDIA GPUs. And it's not, again, it's not the component being required for PyTorch, so for Stable Diffusion. The component which is required for PyTorch is MyOpen, and as you can see, it is currently not available. On the PyTorch GitHub page, there is another interesting comment. We already know that MyOpen is missing, and here is even a link to the related pull request to MyOpen. On the ROCm MyOpen GitHub page, we can indeed find a pull request to enable MyOpen on Windows. And good news, it's already closed. But if you scroll down, then we find the work continues in a separate series of pull requests. Now we check the pull requests and check for items related to Windows. As you can see, currently there are still 4 pull requests to go. I had a look at the latest closed pull requests, and there is indeed some movement. Nevertheless, most of these pull requests had a duration from 1 to 2 months. To summarize, it really seems both the ROCm team and the PyTorch team are willing to have a running version of PyTorch based on ROCm for Windows, which is the requirement for Stable Diffusion. But as you have seen, both on the ROCm side as well as on the PyTorch side, there is still development to be done. Don't count the release of PyTorch on ROCm and Windows in weeks. Count it, well, in months. Nevertheless, now you can check yourself when the MyOpen development has been finished on the ROCm side. Just check for the open pull requests, and I'm sure it will be announced in the MyOpen README. There's another source which can be checked, and it's the documentation of MyOpen. I have the impression it's not updated very frequently. At least version 2.19 is already released and it's not even listed here. Regarding PyTorch, Rockham's support for Windows, well, check this webpage. And the official announcement for PyTorch and Rockham for Windows, well, I'm sure that will be here. Well, now you know how to get the latest information about the stable diffusion requirement PyTorch on Rockham and Windows. Or you can simply subscribe to this channel, I will tell you for sure. In the second part of this video, we want to speed up stable diffusion with AMD on Windows by using Microsoft OLIVE ONNX. As a preparation, we have to install JIT and Miniconda. The installation both of JIT and Miniconda is straightforward, so you shouldn't expect any trouble here. For JIT, choose the 64-bit Windows setup, for Miniconda the Windows 64-bit version. After installing Miniconda, you will find on your PC an Anaconda prompt and an Anaconda PowerShell. We will use the Anaconda prompt. Choose a suitable directory. We create the Conda environment for the automatic OLIVE web UI, including Python 3.10. We activate the newly created environment. Now we clone a popular version of the Windows Stable Diffusion web UI. We enter the newly created directory, update the submodules, and start the backend of the web UI. The first run takes several minutes as it prepares the required packages. You start the web UI by using this URL. As you can see, the Stable Diffusion model failed to load. The reason is now we have to create the ONNX model. We change the tab to OLIVE. Microsoft OLIVE is a tool which optimizes a given source model, resulting in an ONNX-based model and a much faster toolchain based on this ONNX model. Optimize ONNX model. The required information is already entered here, so we can just choose Optimize model using OLIVE. This will take some time. Don't be confused by the keyword no GPU for ONX runtime. The reason is the conversion is done by CPU, but once this is finished, the model will be accelerated by GPU. After everything has finished, we can simply refresh and choose the optimized checkpoint. Then we switch to text-to-image. We enter a prompt and select DPM as the sampling method. Then we start generating, and with my graphics card, which is a Radeon 6800, we have nearly 4 iterations per second. Although the picture looks a bit strange, you see it's working and it's quite fast. Without ONNX, my Radeon 6800 makes one iteration in around 1.7 seconds. So the described ONNX solution is 7 times faster. What's left is Stable Diffusion XL. Well, frankly speaking, this is currently not working with this package. But I'll show you what to do in case it's finished and how to use Stable Diffusion XL with this UI. Go to Hugging Face, search for Stability AI, select the XL model, and in Files and Versions, download the Safe Tensors. Put the files into Stable Diffusion Web UI, Models, Stable Diffusion. Go back to the UI, select OLIVE, Optimize Checkpoint. As we put the model into the right directory, The name of the subdirectory is not required here. This should be the DXL version. And here we simply add the image size. And of course, it should be set to the 1024. Sampling method, I think best is DPM here. As of today, you have to disable the safety checker. Now, press the optimize button. Now, similar to the stable diffusion model before, an optimized SDXL version is created. Well, on my machine it crashed, and as I've seen in the related JIT repository, there is still some work to be done. The link to the repository is in the description below. You might check yourself if there has been some progress so that you can even use the SDXL version. Side note, don't expect it to work with less than 16 GB VRAM. So far, we only have considered automatic 1111 web UI, and for sure you are keen on knowing how to handle Comfy UI. In fact, I still haven't found a solution for running it on Windows. As of today, if you want to run Comfy UI with AMD, the only solution is Linux. If you want to try, check my video on how to run Comfy UI and automatic 1111 web UI with AMD on Linux. And if you don't have a Linux installation, check my video about creating an Ubuntu Linux USB flash drive. If this video has helped you speeding up stable diffusion with your AMD graphics card, or you found the information about ROCm useful, please consider leaving a like or a comment.